Well, protests, marches, uncivil discourse, you know, lately all have seemed like a new way of life for many Americans. Tulsa has certainly seen its fair share as well. With the release of the Tulsa Equality Indicators report, we know that we have work to do in addressing our inequities and inequalities. Community correspondent Risha Grant and 2WorksView's Corey Duke focus on those issues tonight in Just Us.
So what do you see as Tulsa's biggest inequality?
Inequality with poverty and being able to get like our resources that we need in our community, education, our health system, you know, mostly that is a struggle, you know, every day.
It's too expensive for people who work to even get it. You work and work and then most of your money goes for food or rent and you don't have enough left to pay health care.
As a diversity expert who has spoken in different parts of the world, I get firsthand knowledge of how people are dealing with social issues in their communities and workplaces. The reality is, if we don't talk it out, we'll act it out. And that's what we're seeing. The feelings of hopelessness, weariness, being enraged and outdone are running rampant. The fight for equality has been infinite, but now we need a new focus. I'm talking equity. It gives us the tools to all start at the same place. It's the only way we have any real chance at equality. I mean, think about it. There will always be someone who's faster, makes more money, lives in bigger houses. We'll never all be equal from that standpoint. But if we can achieve equity, it will give us access to things like education, healthcare, and wealth building. Equality definitely promotes fairness, but only if we all start from the same place. After all, it's just us.
Risha and I will be working together on Just Us stories you'll see only on 2WorksForYou. You can find out more and share your input on our website. Just check out kgrh.com/justus.